All right, someone. I have done the basements. I've put all the doors on both floors, and I've created the entrance from the kitchen to the basement. So there's what the doors look like. You probably have to jig these around a little bit. Are they sitting flush on the floor? Yeah, they are. You probably won't see that in game. But yeah, there's a tiny smidge between that and the edge of the frame. So you could move it up at grid 0.125 if you're really that bothered. Let's hide all of his portals for now. So there's what all the this is what the upstairs floor looks like. I don't know if I showed you these. I put these little tables in here on the ends. You can get rid of them if you want. You already know about the secret room. What else? There's the door on the dining room, and then the lounge, I guess, for want of a better description. Oops, I forgot to. There's a door that escaped my gaze. I forgot to slice up the thingamabob, the caulk, and then put a door there. This door open the right way, it opens that way, and we want it to open that way. Nope. Right. I'm sure I put a door that opens the opposite way somewhere on this floor. Oh, I'm gonna have to replace that one as well because that's opening the wrong way. And so is that one. I by the wrong way, I mean these models have the origin on that side, so that door would open from it would open to the right eye that way. We don't want to do we want to open into the bedroom, so let's get rid of both of them because it looks like I need the same doorway. On the toilet door, as well as those two bedrooms. Now, where did I put these? Oh, wrong one. That one. So now that'll open to the left. And then that means all the doors then are done on all these floors. I tweaked the guest bathroom a little bit more. I don't know if I think I've shown you this already. I've still got to fix the bottom of that bath. Put a little furnace in all the little rooms. Right, so that's the first floor. Let's move those two doors to that layer. I've still got to build the roulette table for the gambling room, so I'll be doing that later on today. Else? Oh, I'll create the skins for those tables and create the tall versions of those little stools. So basically, they mimic the original stools. But these are my models with the matching textures to match the tables, etc., of the bar and then tall stools. Put some decoration on the walls. And as per Spring's suggestion, you can't see it, let me unhide his portals. That skin I've applied to that chandelier is one I've created that hides that chain, because thankfully he put a single, as he mentioned, a single texture on the chain, so it means when you hide no draw textures, you don't see the chain anymore. And what I've done is I've used the pull chain, spun it the wrong way around, and that gives me my ceiling mount. I furnished the, I don't know what you call this bit, stair bottom area. So I've given it a little grandfather clock, painting, and a commode. And then I've put four little, I've resized these columns. I've tried using the, oops, what's happened there? The model resize technique, but the only problem that I found with that is it resizes in all axes all at the same time, whereas some of the time I don't want to do that. I just, in this case, I wanted to keep the height the same but do the X and Y different. So these are those columns but made smaller to give this area here a bit of bling as you walk in, a bit of sort of Baffert's style, as it were, but on a smaller scale. And then the kitchen is obviously made smaller because I had to make a little hallway to go down to the basement. Had to put an obtuse corner in there to fill that gap. Otherwise you would see the, if I put that up to there, you'd basically, I want a different texture on that bit. So I've had to sort of finagle that one, and it looks pretty good. Put a separate window there, put a window there to the kitchen, because obviously the window that used to be there is now blocked by that hallway. But now that the kitchen looks a bit more busy, it doesn't look like it's got massive amounts of space. I could probably put some bits and bobs in here. Oh yeah, where did I stick that? That, I might move that into to there. See what that looks like. Yeah. No, maybe not. I can jury. When I say we go in game, we can have a look and see. I've still got a pipe to put the pipe on this to go out through the wall. I might even move that whole stove over a bit. Yeah, there we go. I don't know if this chandelier is down too low. Yeah, it is. I might have to shrink that model down a little bit because it's hanging a good section below, and basically don't know whether the AI will whack their heads off the bottom of that. We'll have to see in game. Right, so that's the ground area. All the doors are on that as well. Now onto the basement. So you walk down those stairs into this. This is the first area. I've just populated it with a couple of barrels, large ones for beer, I guess. And then we've got the little boiler room that I've created. This is Spring's existing prefab. And then I've put on a little, to make it into a proper boiler, something Milan created for one of my missions years ago. I've modified it and turned it into a little furnace. With a little steam relief valve, so if it gets too hot, I think it's believable enough. So this provides a hot water for the place. So for the hot water pipes and stuff that you see coming up to the, where is it? Those pipes there, provides the hot water there for the boss, etc. Look at that. Even without trying, it almost lines up. Nice. That bit there will go, probably I'll run a pipe that goes out and up the side of the building. Maybe there, and then it comes out. So when you go to the outside, you'll see the smoke coming off the boiler or whatever. Anyway, I suppose for want of the better way to describe this, the boiler functions the same way the boiler in a locomotive does, as in all the hot gases go up through the boiler. It's got loads of pipes that has all the water in it, and then whatever exhaust fumes goes out through there. That bit there is just the hot water that goes off to the rest of the house, and then you've got steam relief valve there, another steam relief valve there. Yeah, so it sort of loosely follows normal engineering principles, so I'm happy with that. So there you go. So that's it. So basically all that's left now is the outside the stables, if there is one. No, you didn't create one. You just create outside toilets for the guards, so you can do that. What's that? It looks like a garden hut. Gardener's hut. Yep, alright, we'll have to build you another one of them. In fact, I've got a very, very nice hut for a as unreleased mission from the Crucibles campaign that we can plonk in there. I think you'll like that little garden shed that I'll stick there. And then the next big phase will be building the streets that go around the front and the back garden. So the front garden's going to be there, rear garden's going to be there. And obviously the wall, I think what I'll do is have houses or walls or something that breaks up so you can't run all the way around. And have streets, aka Baffert style, that you can come into the build. You know, you can get to see the sides of the manor, but you won't be able to get into it, etc. What are we up to? All right, 11 minutes. All right, this is a very short one. It was just to give you an update of what's been built so far. I shall speak to you soon.